This video has been created for the educational purposes only. Dear students, in this lab demonstration, we will discuss how we can dye cellulosic fabrics using direct dyes. The direct dyes are also called substantive dyes because they have the affinity or substantivity. The affinity and substantivity, these are two different things. So we will discuss these in details in our classroom. Substantive dyes means they have substantivity towards cellulosic fabrics, and these were discovered in 1883. So the first synthesized direct dye was yellow dye, and these are defined according to SDC as anionic dyes substantive to cellulose when applied from an aqueous bath containing electrolytes. The direct dyes are classified in class A, B, and C. Class A means the self-leveling dyes. These dyes don't require any sort of salt or temperature controlled environment to get a level shade. Class B dyes are salt controllable dyes. This means we can add and control the dyeing behavior using the salt. In other words, the class B direct dyes are sensitive to the salt addition. And the third, the class C type of direct dyes are temperature controllable dyes. So similarly, like class B, as they were the salt controllable dyes, these are temperature controllable dyes. This means the leveling can be achieved if the temperature is controlled. Students, there are various benefits to select direct dyes for our cellulosic fabrics. First of all, it is very easy to apply. Then we don't need to have any sort of fixing agents. This means the cost has been saved, and it is cheap as well and available in various shades, means green, red, blue, yellow, black. So if the range is wide, we can select any sort of shade that is the requirement of customer, and they have moderate to high light fastness. This means these are not sensitive to light. And then we have short dyeing time. This means we are saving our time. The production will be high as well. Whenever there is something good, there is something bad as well. So the limitation of direct dyes is the poor wash fastness. So whenever you will wash your fabric, you will see the color bleeding out of your fabrics. You can see here in this picture. When you try to wash or dip your fabric inside water, it bleeds. In other words, if these dyes are very easy to apply, they are very easy to be removed as well, because they are only being fixed with the help of van der Waal forces and hydrogen bonding. There is no covalent bond or ionic bond, so they are easy to be removed as well. The direct dye auxiliaries and chemicals include the direct dye. Definitely we are doing exhaust dyeing, so we will select direct dye on the weight of fabric. And then we have wetting agent, we have sequestering agent, we have salt. So there is a range of salt from 10 to 40 gram per liter or even higher. So this depends upon the shade, how darker shade you are going to achieve, and how you have selected the profile as well as the dye class. And then the time required is 30 to 50 minutes, and the temperature is near boil, 90 to 100 degrees centigrade. And then we have to wash off the unfixed dye. This is very important in the dyeing of cellulosic fabric. Washing off process is required, where you have to wash your fabric at near boiling temperature with the help of washing off agents, so that the unfixed dye has been removed properly and it will not come out of the fabric. And there is another step if required, application of cationic fixing agents. This will increase the wash fastness of our direct dyed samples if required. Definitely the cost will be higher if we apply fixing agents, but this depends upon the customers. The recipe calculation is very important in textile processing. So when we are explaining the direct dyeing method using exhaust technique to dye our cellulosic fabrics, we will have to measure the dye amount on the weight of our fabric. So let us suppose here that we have to take 1% of the drag die on the weight of our fabric, and the other auxiliaries include wetting gel 1 gram per liter and salt 20 gram per liter. This is just to give you an idea. So if our fabric has 5 gram weight and we select materials to liquor ratio 1:50, the total liquid will be 5 multiplied by 50 to 50 ml. This has been demonstrated in the previous lab experiments as well. But the problem here is that when we have to take this much fewer quantity of dye, the powder is very hard to accurately measure. So what we do, we make a solution. Here you can see we have written stock solution 1%. This means we add 1 gram of dye in 100 ml of liquid, and then we calculate how much ml of this solution is required. For example, if we have our fabric weight of 5 gram and we require x percentage of on the weight of our fabric of dye, this means here in this case we have 1% drag dye. So this means 5 gram of our fabric multiplied by 1% of the drag dye, it is 0.05 gram. So now you will be able to see that to measure 0.05 gram accurately using a colored substance or powder is difficult. So that is why we have made this solution. So let us remember our FSER metric classes. We know the stoichiometric calculations. So if we have added 1 gram of dye in 100 ml of liquid, this means 100 ml of liquid has 1 gram of dye, and 1 ml of liquid will have 1 by 100 gram of dye, means 0.01 gram. So how much dye is required? We require 0.05 gram and 1 ml has 0.01 gram. So if we multiply it with 5, in other words, if we take 5 ml of this liquid, we will have 0.05 gram of dye. So this is just as simple. So I think you all are aware of these sort of calculations. So now let us move towards another important thing regarding this calculation. We know that the total liquid was 5:50, 5 gram fabric weight, 1:50 of material to liquor ratio, this means 250 ml, but we cannot add 250 ml in our dyeing solution. Why? Because we have to take into consideration this liquid as well that we have prepared to dissolve our dye. In other words, if we add 250 ml first, then add 5 ml, our material to liquor ratio will not be 1:50. So that is why we have first to calculate how much liquid we will add using our dye solution. So in this case, we added liquid having dye solution only 5 ml. So we will subtract it from 250. So another thing that is important to tell students here is that the calculation of other auxiliaries. So we have already calculated the dye, and now we have to go for the wetting agent or salt or other sort of auxiliaries. So let us take the example of salt. So as we know, we have to calculate our salt quantity. So in this example, if we have to add 20 gram of salt in 1 liter of liquid or dyeing solution, then we have to calculate that as well. So using the same stoichiometric calculations, if 1000 ml of liquid is supposed to have 20 gram of salt, then 1 ml of liquid should have 20 by 1000 gram of salt. So we have 250 ml of liquid. This means we will have 20 multiplied by 250 divided by 1000 is equal to 10 gram of salt. So we have to add 10 gram of salt in our total liquid of 250 ml. So dear students, let's start our experiment.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Dear students, today we have to dye our cotton fabrics using direct dyes in an exhaust way. So what are the direct dyes? Direct dyes, as the name suggests, these are applied without the addition of any alkali or and it can be applied directly on the cellulosic fabrics. So the direct dyes, they are not fixed properly, and they are, like you can say, hold it there inside the fibers with van der Waal forces or hydrogen bonding. Therefore, their fastness is very poor. So whenever you will wash a direct dyed fabric, you will see the dye bleeding out of the fabric. So that is why we can say the direct dyes are cheapest, oldest, but they are not environmental friendly, as every time you wash the fabric, there will be the color discharge, and it is not good as well regarding customers. So if your fabric is bleeding the color out, you will not like the fabric. So let me demonstrate the release. So definitely we will let the specification as described earlier in previous experiments, what is the role of stressing agent, and then we will have the wetting agent as well, and then we will only need salt. So technically there are three classes of direct dyes, class A, B and C. The A class is self-leveling. This means you don't have to add anything else, the dyes have the ability to level themselves. The second is salt controlled dyes. This means the addition of salt will have a significant effect on your dyeing behavior. And the third is so you can control the temperature to control your dyeing behavior of direct dyes. We have made the fabric, it is 5 grams. So keeping the material to liquid ratio same as per previous experiments, 1:50 means 250 ml of water we will add in total. So we have to take into consideration the liquid here, as we have already demonstrated in the previous experiments. Now we will add our fabric inside the container with our dyes, and then we will start to heat our direct dye at elevated temperatures, 80 to 90 degrees centigrade, and then we will add the salt after some time in at least two portions, so that there is not a rush and we get a level dye. So let's add the remaining water inside our container. So it is 100 ml, 200 ml. Then we have to add our dye inside our container, and we have already know that how much dye is inside the solution using the stoichiometric calculations, and then we will you can say subtract the amount of liquid here from the total liquid. Now we have added our fabric inside that. So now we will start to heat it gradually. Now we will start to increase our temperature slowly. We have added the salt in two portions, and the temperature is now nearing the 90 degree centigrade. When it goes to 90, then we will measure the time required to dye our fabric. Now the required time is complete, students. Now we will turn off the machine and we will wash our fabric as we have demonstrated earlier in the previous experiments. So now we will drain the solution, and now we will wash the fabric thoroughly with hot water and soaking of agent as demonstrated earlier, so that the unfixed dye has been removed properly, and then we can also do the cationic fixing agent treatment if we require a good fastness property. So students, this is the fabric that is bleached fabric ready to dye, and we have dyes using this solution, and here is the fabric that has been direct dyed using exhaust method. So there are various variations and various parameters that are important to consider, like the amount of salt, amount of alkali, the amount of wetting agent, stressing agent, the time, temperature. Your teacher will let you know the exact amounts.